Welcome to sunny Bologna and MCN's test of the three Scramblers. First of all, we have this one. This is the Triumph Street Scrambler. It's basically a Triumph Street Twin, which is a 900cc water-cooled parallel twin, but with a 19-inch front wheel, 17-inch back, twin high-level pipes, and a bit of a Scrambler styling, complete with knobbly tyres. Then we have Ducati's offering, which is the latest introduction to the Scrambler range. This is a Scrambler Desert Sled. A desert sled is effectively what the Americans call an off-road bike that goes through the desert. It's a term that originated in the 1950s and 60s. Now, to sled the Scrambler, what Ducati have done, they've made a bit more of an effort than some of the others in a lot of ways. The frame is kind of similar to the standard Scrambler. It's been braced at the back. The swing arms have been given more of an angle in it to raise the whole bike. It's got fully adjustable suspension, which is the first of the Scramblers. Off-road wheels, off-road tyres, little details like a headlight grille, which again was what the desert bikes used to have in America in the Californian races. Again, you've got the same engine as the rest of the Scrambler age, the 803cc Desmo Due, so it's an air-cooled motor. And finally, we have the bike that's actually the BMW R9T Scrambler, which came out last year. Again, it's the same, effectively the same chassis as the original R9T, but it's got a few details to make it more basic and more stripped back for the Scrambler look. You've got the air-cooled boxer engine, which is the same as the R9T, but you've got conventional forks, conventional brakes, high set of bars, single front headlamp, and these lovely twin stack pipes. Again, this is all giving it the Scrambler look. Knobbly tyres or semi-knobbly tyres. This one actually has the more road orientated tyres. You can decide which option you want when you order your Scrambler. You can go for more knobbly, more road tyres. And again, this has it's got spoke wheels where the standard bike comes with the cast wheels. I think it's about £350 extra to pop on your spoke wheels. We've been riding these bikes both on the road and off the road, which on a couple of these bikes is a little bit exciting. As you can imagine, the BMW R9T Scrambler is effectively a scrambler for the road. It's a kind of a styling exercise. It can go off road, but realistically, it's more of a road bike, and it's a really, really nice road bike. It's big, it's solid. It's got a lot of punch on it as well, thanks to the boxer engine. It's a lovely, lovely road bike, and I kind of think it's quite a practical scrambler. You can use this day to day because, well, it's effectively an old school GS, but with a really good look about it. Really nice bike to road, but off road, you got a lot of weight here. Again, we're talking options here. It comes ABS as standard, but this one has traction control, which is an optional extra. Nice thing is you can flick a button, turn the ABS, turn traction control off, and get drifting it, which you can do, especially if you have the road tires rather than knobbly ones. Lovely looking bike, but if you're going to go off road, you really want to be looking towards this one. Now, people look at Ducati's Scrambler range, they think, oh, they're styling exercises. This one is not a styling exercise. This is a proper off-road bike. It is a cracking little machine. Compared to both the Triumph and the BMW, Ducati have given it really good suspension. So when you're going off-road, you can actually use it off-road. The suspension can take bumps. It's not this thing will ping itself off its stops because it's just too soft suspension, so will Triumph. This one can be ridden off-road. It's a very, very competent off-road bike, which is surprising because you don't expect that from one of the Scramblers. Styling-wise, it looks fantastic. It's a really nice bike. The air-cooled engine is a lovely one to ride. But the good thing is it works on the road as well. You've got a nice, upright, kind of aggressive riding position, which is good. And it feels like you want your Scrambler to feel, if you're more into your motocross or your proper off-road style, really, really nice bike. And actually, genuinely surprising, especially for people who, like I say, tend to write off Scramblers as styling exercises. And finally, we have the Street Scrambler from Triumph. Now, Triumph got a bit of a history with Scramblers, both old Triumph, pre-Hinckley, and also the current Hinckley Triumph ones, because obviously the old Bonneville was sold in Scrambler form as well. A lot like the BMW, this is effectively a road bike given a Scrambler look. They like to pretend it's got off-road potential, but it's not much more than the gravel drive, just purely because your suspension's soft, it's quite low. But in a lot of ways, that makes it a really nice road bike, similar to the BMW. But this thing's just a little bit softer. The parallel twin engine, it's got spirit on it, the 900. It's a really nice engine. It's got a nice little sound to it. It thuds along really pleasantly. You've got a lovely low seat height, making this a great town bike. You've got a light clutch. But what's interesting about this thing is, as standard, you get traction control, you get ABS, which is quite a nice thing to have on what is a relatively cheap motorcycle. For town riding, gentle cruising, you do kind of look at this one and think, actually, this is one of the better ones, well, better one of these three for just relaxed riding. This is the best off-roader, also very, very competent town, and the BMW is also a competent town, but it is quite big. This is just a lovely, lovely bike for riding around towns. And if styling, looking good, gentle riding, maybe you're a newer rider, because I think this one can also be got in A2 legal format. Really good, interesting bike to ride and really fun. And also very, very good looking with a Triumph badge. And you wouldn't know it's water cooled. Yeah, it's got a radiator tucked at the front, but you've got lovely fins. It doesn't shout water cooling. Like all of the modern Triumph range, they've got the styling right, and that's so crucial. Which is the winner for us? I've got to look and say, for me, the Ducati comes out on top. It's just such an impressive bike, not only off-road, on-road it's got the feel, and if you like that sort of macho, aggressive, and you want Scramblers to have a little bit of punch about them, this is a really good bike for that. There again, if you want to go a little bit more distance-wise, you'd probably want to better go towards the larger engine of the BMW, but again, you are paying a little bit more for it. But for town cruising, I would be tempted to go towards this one, because this is the more relaxed of the three. So overall, my money would be with this one. Impressive more than I thought it would do. But really, all these Scrams are lovely, lovely bikes to ride. It depends on exactly what you want to do with it. Off-road, on-road, city. You take your pick.